Hello friends, today we have come here to introduce Rahul Nandwani, All India Rank 19 CA Final, and we have a great pleasure in meeting him. We first congratulate him for his great success, and we have Rahul Nandwani. Rahul, congratulations.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Okay, can you express the feelings, you know, how after getting All India Rank 19, that's how you are feeling?
It has been a really happy feeling, it has been surreal, and I believe it was completely unexpected because CA Final has a lot of theory papers, practical papers, so you can't really expect a rank, and you know, you can't expect greater than 70 marks in anything. You always assume you'll get 50 or 60. So it has been really unexpected and a really happy feeling. So everyone is happy, my family and my friends and everyone. So it has been really great.
Now we are also very proud that you have been, you know, you have put a lot of hard work. You must know that only because of your hard work and dedication, focus, and you know, the commitment which you have put, you know, that is the reason you have seen reward. I'm very glad to know that AgentNext also played a big part. Now, could you tell the broad strategy you adopted to get this rank?
So I studied for 4.5 months. So 15 days I kept as buffer, and overall I split 90 days into 8 subjects. And the remaining 30 days was for revision and mock test. So I believe you should be committed to the plan you have set in place, and you should do weekly reviews as to where you are lacking and put more efforts into those things. And ICAI material, PMs and AgentNext, you know, the notes really helped. And also you should focus on mock tests and practicing the papers as well, because that is crucial in at least practical subjects to recognize whether or not you are able to complete the entire paper or not. So that has been really important.
Okay, good, nice to hear that. See, I just want to help the modern day students, you know, many of them put a lot of hard work, many of them dedicate themselves, you know, and you know, everyone has a focus. Now if I want to ask you, out of focus, dedication and hard work, if I tell you to prioritize, so which you will keep number one, number two and number three?
So number one would be focus. You should know where you have to put in efforts, and then the next thing would be dedication. You have to be dedicated in your efforts, and hard work is always there. Without hard work, dedication and focus will also not be helpful as such.
Well, that's so great. Very nice to hear. This is the correct process of actually succeeding, because you know, without focus, if you put hard work, it's of no use. Again, if you are not dedicated towards any task, you know, absolutely perfectly you said. You have scored 90 marks in SFM.
Yes.
You know, many students fear finance, and in this paper you have scored 90 marks. You know, could you tell me, you know, do you like this paper very much, or are you used to studying this paper too much? You know, what is the broad strategy adopted to get such a high mark?
So out of all the papers, SFM was my favorite paper. I really loved the concepts and, you know, the theories it had, like put call theory or any theories. And I really like to follow the market as well, the news and, you know, the stock market in general. And also your notes particularly help, because you used to make us write the conceptual understanding behind the notes as well to reinforce during our study leave or when we are revising. So that really helped. Your market experience, you know, you have 30 plus of experience in the actual market, so you used to give us example. I remember one thing you had told us, that you know, if for long the reverse position should be you know, should be square, and for short it should be cover. So these small things don't matter that much to us in the class. It feels like it doesn't matter, but these are really helpful for us to easily understand and gauge the concepts broadly. And also your notes were really helpful. It covered all the past papers. So in PM also I used to eliminate almost half the questions, because they were already covered in class conceptually. So I didn't have to memorize anything. I just understood it conceptually, and the paper I scored, I attempted all 100 marks in SFM. So I scored 90 out of that, so that's really great.
Did you give importance to theory also? Did you attempt theory?
No, I didn't attempt theory. No.
So without attempting theory, you could score 90 marks.
90, exactly.
So that's good. That's quite good. And how many hours actually you must have dedicated to study complete SFM?
SFM, I believe around 12-13 days. So around 10 hours per day for 12-13 days. So 120-130 hours.
How many revisions you could do?
Revisions, only one revision.
One revision. How important was execution on the exam day?
Execution, you have to be really quick. You have to read the question and understand how you have to approach it, because you also have to explain the understanding. You can't just write a final answer by calculating on the calculator. So you have to be quick in your thinking and the approach. And your lectures, of course, you were always teaching us conceptually how to approach a problem. I remember you covered Forex for, I believe, more than 2 weeks you have covered Forex. So that was really helpful in understanding what the code was and how, which code do we require. This, you had given us broad steps how to approach a Forex problem. That the first step was which code is given, which code is required, what is the quantum, then what hedge is required. So those concepts really helped in the actual execution in the exam.
Okay, good. I also came to know that you are with Asian Exchange IPCC.
Yes.
So you undertook all the 8 papers of CA panel.
Yes.
Now could you broadly tell me, you know, how faculties of AGNX helped you to score very good marks? Because I saw your mark sheet has scored quite good marks in the group, all the papers of group 2 and group 1 also. You know, wide, very, you have done a, you can say a proper average. So what is the secret, means how AGNX helped you in this objective?
So Anuj sir's classes were really great. You know, he never made us memorize anything. He explained everything conceptually. I remember reading it in the preface that costing is just about solving problems. So he made us solve around 200 problems or 100 problems in marginal costing. And his entire book was really comprehensive. And after that, solving PM, half the problems were eliminated because half the concepts and the sums were actually done in class. So Anuj sir was a great class. And after that, FR Viral sir really helped with AS. He used to teach us from bare AS. So that helped in writing the actual AS language in the exam. So if you study from, say, an author who usually writes his own language, those are not really valued in the exam. So if you write the language of the AS, they know that you have actually studied it in detail and it reflects. So it gives you an edge and it gives you full marks out of 4. Say if they are awarding someone else 2.5 marks, they'll give you 3.5 marks out of it. So the language really helps. And for audit, Sachin sir really helped with ethics. In essays, I remember standards on auditing, he used to make us draw charts of essays, all the standards of auditing. So that really helped in grasping the overview and also for revision. And for ethics, I remember each and every clause, he used to give us an objective behind the clause to understand why the clause is in place, rather than just memorizing that there's this clause 1 in first schedule of part 1. We used to understand why the clause is in place, and since he's also been practicing, I believe, for 10-12 years, so his practical knowledge also helped in reality how these clauses are put into effect. And for, I believe, law, IDT and I believe ISCA was really helpful as well.
DT.
And DT, particularly DT was great. Arish sir was really great. His lectures were comprehensive. I believe Arish sir's lectures span more hours than any other class. And secondly, he used to give us summary notes. So an entire book of 300 pages is summarized in 100 pages. So it is really great in large day revisions for revising on your own when you don't have time. So that has really helped. And his lectures were really comprehensive. He used to go in detail each and every lecture. And also his amendment lecture. Also, I would like to point out in our actual paper, Matt under Ind AS was asked. But Ari sir, of all the faculties, I believe, had uploaded a lecture on YouTube, available for all. And I had also studied from that lecture, and that really helped me score 10 marks where everyone else left that question entirely. And also the amendment lectures, the case law lectures he used to keep, you know, just before the attempt. So that also really helped. So Arish sir's lectures were also really good.
So all in all the 8 papers actually,
yeah,
you get
good.
So you know, it's very difficult for a student to actually pick an institute and take or join all the 8 papers, and you have proved that, you know, joining all the 8 papers and one institute and getting, so you got value for money, if you can say that.
Exactly.
Absolutely. Okay. Now, what are your future, one more thing before I just cut short. When you joined AJNX, you know, you must have got some reference, you know, somebody would have studied here or someone, and then you would have been attracted to some features of AJNX. You know, what actually made you join? No, why you joined AJNX?
So when I was in college, I was asking around which class to join. Many of the seniors were from AJ, or So they were from AJ. So they really advised me that it was really great and conceptual. Anuj Sir's lecture, Ari Sir, and Sridhar Sir, you and that. So they really advised that it is really great for all the practical subject as well as the theory subjects. So I went with their advice and I'm happy with it. Yes, sir.
And what other thing you would have heard? Heard about AJNEXT.
AJNEXT now they have started with new course elective papers as well, FSCM and I believe international taxation, and also AJ for old course as well as new course has crash courses, test series, and I believe has a guidance as well. If you write your paper after test series, they tell you where you have gone wrong and where there is a scope for improvement. So test series is also a must in AJ. If you and outsiders can also join. Also crash courses, if you have not cleared for some reason or if a group is pending, you can join AJ to learn about,
So this and all, how you came to know? With somebody,
The promotional material, I believe. I follow the AJ page, so I know about the promotion.
Because, a student who has passed, who is on the rank, who has secured rank, generally, this information. So as a student, you people gather a lot of information before joining. So that is the curiosity with which I asked the question. Okay. Now, what are your plans? Where you are going to go?
So in the future, I would like to join a job. I would like to take up a job, and particularly in finance, because that interests me really well. And that's it. I'll take up a job.
What about a job in which which department of finance? Finance is ocean.
Yeah.
So you have got investment banking, you have got M&A advisory, you have got equity research, you have got fund management, you have got bank. There are so many, which area actually interests you a lot?
Area-wise, I would believe equity research, credit analysis, and something in modeling would really interest me.
Okay. Good. Now, Rahul, actually, it was nice talking to you. It was, I can say, it's a great pleasure in actually meeting you and knowing that the faculties of AJNEXT have contributed to your success. We all the faculties on behalf of AJNEXT, I congratulate you. And I wish you a great success for future.
Thank you.
Thank you.